I have a confession to make. I love sprint reviews. A sprint review or demo is so much more than a meeting. Demos are the cornerstone on which you can build better software, stronger teams, and a healthier culture. Hi, I'm Megan Cook, Group Product Manager for Jira Software Cloud. In today's episode, we'll talk about sprint reviews, the purpose they serve, the attendees and their roles, and steps for running them. By now, you should know the basics of planning a sprint and how to do daily stand-ups. Now, imagine you've reached the end of your sprint. All right, it's time to show off your work and reflect on how things went at the sprint review ceremony. Start by gathering everyone from the Scrum Master, development team, and product owner to designers, writers, and analysts in a room with a screen that everyone can see. You'll need to block a fair amount of time. A safe rule of thumb is 5 minutes per person, so everyone has 5 minutes to demo what they're working on. Now that you've set the stage, it's time to kick off the ceremony. So how do you do a sprint review? Well, there are four key steps. Review what's done and not done, demo the work, review key metrics, review and revise the product backlog. Let's take a closer look at what happens during each step. Beginning with step one, review what's done and not done. The product owner begins the sprint review by reviewing the product backlog and explaining which items are done and not done yet. Next, the development team leads step two, demonstrating the work they've completed. Think of this as part of the meeting like show and tell. Each member of the team demos what they completed and answers questions about what was done and why. It's a great time to celebrate the team and everyone's accomplishments during an iteration. However, it's not all celebration. Earlier, the team planned and prioritized this work, likely with a user story or ticket, and now has a chance to review what's actually been delivered. Now the team can ask questions and make observations about the direction that was actually implemented. Will it satisfy the customer's problem? Does it account for internal dependencies? These demos are invaluable for steering your teammates in the right direction before they push code to production. At Atlassian, we demo each and every week, so the team is constantly course-correcting the small decisions before they snowball into big mistakes. Then in step three, the team reviews the key metrics that they're working towards. Ideally, you are delivering working software that does something like improves performance, drives customer behavior, or some other measurable outcome. This meeting is a great time to review these metrics and make sure that what we demo is going to move those metrics and get closer to your goals. The last step is reviewing and revising the product backlog. Now that the team has seen what has been built, it's good to take another look at what's up next. Teams often add new user stories or remove old ones as the implementations and intended effects become clear in the demo. If a new screen needs a fresh design or copy, we can take this time to kick that project off with design and UX. The final result of the sprint review ceremony is a revised product backlog that informs the next sprint planning meeting. If you follow all these steps, you'll have all the bases covered for sprint reviews as part of a traditional Scrum framework. If you want to take it one step further, I'd love to share how at Atlassian we've made this ceremony part of a broader demo culture. We believe that all product teams should have weekly demos with the entire team. Done well, these meetings create alignment across the entire team, shared learning, customer focus, and raises the bar for accountability. The entire team has a responsibility to ask questions, challenge, and share lessons with the presenter. It isn't just the job of a manager or a boss. This creates demos that are collaborative, dynamic, energizing, and informative for all. So whether you're studying up for your first sprint review, or you're refining your current practice, I know these steps will come in handy. Although sprint reviews happen at the end of a sprint, it's not the final step. That's where retrospectives come in. Subscribe to our channel or cruise on over to videos on retrospectives to learn how to finish your sprint on the right foot.